Halftime. Full time. Extra time. Debonair's Pizza. Try something amazing.
Welcome to another edition of Kickoff on the Couch, proudly brought to you by Debonair's Pizza. Alongside me, my esteemed colleagues Mark Herman and Nick Zed. Gentlemen, this past weekend was Telkom Knockout. Four teams whittled down to two, and we've got SuperSport and Cape Town City left to battle out in the final. Mark, your thoughts on SuperSport and their recent good run of form under Stuart Baxter?
You know, SuperSport, when Baxter took over, SuperSport, one of the clubs that we all thought might have a good chance for one of the cups this season. You know, he took over a solid squad, brought about some more organisation, and I think they've been playing that way recently. You can see that they're very organised defensively, and obviously have started scoring a few goals as well. The game against Pirates, I think, it was a typical cup game. I think either team could have won. Obviously, it wasn't like the 6-1. Pirates obviously bouncing back and showing that, you know, they didn't become a bad team overnight. But I think Baxter's has got them to have that winning mentality. And I think looking ahead to the final, I think they might be favourites to edge City, even though City are probably in better form goals-wise.
Nick, on that note, Cape Town City can make history, very short club history so far, and they're ready into the final. Obviously, Eric Tinkler having a big influence there.
Yeah, I mean, you'd have to say they're one of the best teams in the PSL at the moment going forward. They do have their problems defensively and a little bit of naivety sometimes in their defensive midfield. But going forward, they look absolutely fantastic. They can score almost at will, as we saw against Free State Stars. They won 4-1, but it could have been 8-1 very, very easily. Guys like Lebo Manyama, Aubrey Ngoma, Bongi Jaiya, and not forgetting Sibusiso Masina, who's been excellent, I've thought, in the last few games. They really are looking like a quality side, and well done to Eric, you know, who really took over the core of Mpumalanga Black Aces, but had a lot of work to do to knit the squad together. He took a squad of 14 to knit them into a squad of 25, 26, and to do it so quickly has been brilliant.
Changing tack, looking at the reigning league champions and Champions League champions, Mamelodi Sundowns. After their African glory, they've been a little bit inconsistent, a few up and down results, but now really looking the part, coming off the back of a 5-0 drubbing of Highlands Park, and obviously Percy Tau having a great little run of late. Your thoughts on that, Mark?
You know, I can't actually praise Pitso Mutsimane enough, what he's done with that Sundowns team. I mean, a couple of years ago, when they won the league, and then the next season Chiefs came back, you know, slowly but surely, I think since Sundowns stopped their lavish spending, but Pitso's just been tweaking the squad here and there, bringing in a few players. I remember 2 years ago, I think it was a year or two ago, he said, I still have Percy Tau. I still have to bring him in. I think he was playing MDC at that point. And I mean, look at him now. Sundowns now they've had a hectic schedule. They're the African champions. But suddenly Tau's come in and he's looking at the best player in the league at the moment. And I think he's only 22. I mean, there's still a lot more. I think Pizza's been protecting him a bit. But it's going to be difficult to protect him going forward because, I mean, look at his performance against Highlands Park, 3 assists and a goal created by himself. I mean, I think he's got 4 goals and 8 assists already this season. And that's output. It's not only potential. He's actually proving that now. And Sundown's squad, they've got so much depth. I mean, Leonardo Castro and Kama Bulliet, they were sitting on the bench for that Highlands game. It looked like the easiest game they've ever played. And I don't know, I just think that Pizza, what he's done there, that they're playing like a team that understand his tactics completely. As soon as they lose the ball, they get back and they win it. Almost Barcelona-esque, if you don't mind me over-exaggerating. But I really think they've got a good chance in Japan to maybe get to the semi-final. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, looking ahead onto that, Nick, Sundowns next going to... So they've got 2 more local games and then it's Japan. Just what is the mindset going there and mixing it with the best in the world?
Yeah, I think it's going to be fantastic for them. You know, it really does put Sundowns on a global platform. They've certainly grown and enhanced their reputation in Africa, but if they can do well at the Club World Cup, that really put them on the global spotlight, which is exactly, I think, what the owner Patrice Motsepe wants. You know, he's now looking beyond Africa and how to grow this brand. So, yeah, they'll find out this coming weekend who they will potentially play in the first round, because it's between the New Zealand side, Auckland City, and the winner of the the Japanese League Championship, which concludes this weekend. So yeah, after that we'll know who they might get in the quarterfinals, and yeah, we can only just wish them the best.
Mm-hmm. With Sundowns being talk of the town, we've obviously gone big on them in the latest edition of Kickoff Magazine. Some great inside look on their travels to Egypt, and of course looking ahead to Japan. For the non-Sundowns fans, there's plenty more to sink your teeth in, so have a look. Look out for the December edition on shelves now. And that's it for this edition of Kickoff on the Couch, proudly brought to you by Dimbanese. Thanks for joining us.
Surprise them with a Debonair's pizza on the double. That's two large pizzas for only $119.90. Debonair's pizza. Try something amazing.